Hello everyone, I'm Rajeeb Banstola. I'm 19 years old WordPress Theme Developer, currently working at ThemeGrill. And you can find me on Rajeeb Banstola the great on the internet. And today I'm going to be talking about making the WordPress Theme Development better. Your workflow and the process you develop the theme can make better with the help of tools that are available on the internet. So, what I often meet with people is that there are too many tools that I have lost time to learn, and they just don't want to change with what they are doing. So, what I do is I don't use all the tools available on the internet. I choose the best ones, or those ones that work good for me. I don't need all features provided by them. I choose those which are good for me. You can do that for your own. So this is the overview of things I'm going to be talking about. First is starter theme, and back runner, and live video, deploying using Git, CSS preprocessor, git shortcuts, often recommendation, easy for file, and again local environment. So why do we need this? Let's talk about that first. The main reason is it saves my time. It saves your time. If you can use some tools to make the development time less, then it's better to use those tools. And we all know time is equal to $, or freedom, or whatever you like to do. So how do I go on integrating these tools in my workflow? I wrote down my process and identify the points where I can use those tools to do some repetitive and MMM tasks. So let's hear this story. It's about me, and I'm working till late night for some clients, and client doesn't want the new feature I did last week. Now I have to go to all those files in my server and find out the code which is taking those features, and I have to remove those. I tried that, and something is broken. Okay, there must be some better way of tracking those changes so that I can revert back to that. So use Git. Most of you probably know this thing. It is something that is fundamental tool for every team to work. It makes better work with some feature states or maybe some bug fixes without touching the main or master or stable code. So let's get to another story. Here's a current ecosystem developing new team. Most of you probably use any of these two approach. When I first started, I used the first approach. I coded everything from scratch, from all those functions, WordPress functions and styles that were already written by somebody else. But I did that, and I know it was repetitive. It consumed all of the time. So when I developed my second theme, I thought I would be a little smarter and use my own theme scheme. But even using that way, I had to undo a lot of old work. I find that the many components that were in new theme were the old themes, and the old themes had so many things that were not needed for the new theme. So I had to look back and eat all those things and remove all those things. So what's better? Building and using your own starter theme. Of course, there are many starter themes available on this net, like underscore as by automated roots and many others. But what's even better? You can create your own starter theme. You can use your own coding style. Nobody knows the coding style better than you. You can use your own common codes, and you can even get more accessibility features. So here's the second thing: CSS and JS best practices. When I was first introduced to WordPress in development, people talked about all these things like unified HTTP address and unify the size of the download file. And I had to make my JavaScript function and variable names descriptive. But what I learned during my development workflow is that it was a pain to work with unified file. I find it impossible to work with that. So there must be a better way. So I call it contradiction. Though they were the best practices, they contradict with my flow, my workflow. So taxons come to rescue here. Taxons like Runt and Gulp are built on Node.js, and they use npm packages to run packs. You can create a task in GovPackages and add GovPackages you need for the task in package suggestions. You can either use Gov or Grom. I personally prefer Gov. So here is an example of Gov style task. You don't need to use JavaScript to understand this. So this is one of the example of Go tags, and it is named style. The best thing is you can run these tags in your command line using Go style. And what it does for me like is that it looks for the file in SCS, style of SCSS, and it compiles the SCSS file, it auto-prints the file, and it minifies the files, and even renames the files for me. I don't need to do any other things. I need to open some kind of tools to compile here. Sorry, compile a CSS file, or I don't even need to remember the prefixes I need to add. It automatically does that job for me. So this is another tag. It's called script. And what it does is, it looks for all the files in fontin directory, it combines those files, and it unifies the file, and it gives me the unified version of the file by just writing gulp script in the command line. I don't need to use all those tools or something. So this is another thing. I'm hitting F5 button and waiting for my browser to reload the page. It seems like most times you're interested in this thing, but if you take into account all those times you are developing some theme or some for a blog or for a client, then it's much time. So you can also minimize this with Gulp. I define another task called Gulp Watch, and it looks for the changes in the files, and it runs the task defined at the side of the line, and it reloads my browser. All I need is a Chrome extension called Liveload or Mozilla Firefox add-on called Liveload, and it does the job. So this is another confusion I always have. I always end up with like, so my active server is taking too long to upload my files. So I keep on waiting because I have wasted my time for that. So I stop it because it's taking too long. Active is too slow, and it wants me to make the change on the server, and that way I can version control this thing. So you can deploy using git and php load. Example, deployed ini file I use for my company, and it works with git. It only uploads the change file. It will not upload all the files, and I can deploy it just by writing php load on command line. You can check that file. So another thing, first I avoided learning is CSS preprocessor. These are three basic features I personally use: partials, variables, and nesting. And these are all available on these technologies like SAS, release, and status. You can choose any of them. SAS is better and it's more popular. In partials features, you can divide your CSS into logical sections. As you can see, there's separate files for color, layout, typography, the index, and all. And another feature is called variables. You can define variables in your SCSS file, and you can use layers throughout all those SCSS files. And when you're compiling an SCSS file, it gives you normal CSS. You don't have to worry about that thing. And it's like, it's more helpful when you have some kind of color code that's repetitive on all those lines. Like, you can just define a variable, and you can change, and it reflects in your CSS. Another thing I love is nesting. I can write that CSS or SCSS, that means the structure of my HTML. So this is another thing I love, git aliases. And what it does is takes my handy software for git tags. Like I actually discovered in a situation when I had to make some small changes, and like for some changing a simple color code dynamic each to the each and commit that and push that. Using a single command, I can use that to a single command. I just write the command and commit and it will automatically get the file and commit that and push, even push to the server. This is the sample bconfig file I used. And this is another part of me. Hitting Google Edit and I read some new CSS or maybe new PHP function or WordPress function. It's more painful when you have slow internet or maybe some kind of trouble with the internet connection. So what's better? Is offline documentation. I personally use Zero for Windows and you can get that for Linux too. There's a software called Dash for Mac. And it downloads HTML, CSS, JS, PHP, WordPress documentation offline for me. So another thing I like to tell you is easy for file generation. I had one of my colleagues who hated this screen. It doesn't want to open this interface. So I found a way to get rid of this OAP app. So that was the job, and you can see the task I defined here, it's called makebot. And it takes all those things and looks for the file and create a bot file for me. It is more helpful when you have made some changes or updated the version and probably you need a new string, and it's highly probable that you need to create a new bot file. It's very helpful for that situation like that. So I'd like to sum up with a environment theme, like it's called Variant Vagrant Vagrants. It's basically is a demo environment for WordPress. It works with WordPress software like VirtualBox, VMware Fusion, and create a development environment for you. With this entering directly up in your terminal, you can have your one Ubuntu personalized Ubuntu server set up and running in minutes. So my final workflow is like this. I run the backend off, I clone my server thing, I do all of the git commit and dot watch that, and I debug the code using PHP loader. These are the references I use, you can find it online when I made this slide online. So that's it, any questions?